So the winter seems to be coming to an end here in Kansas and Oklahoma and the Southern Great Plains in general. And many of the wheat producers who actually grow wheat as a dual purpose crop, or in other words, for forage and cattle grazing and for grain later on, they need to start looking for the optimal time to remove cattle from wheat pastures if they want to go for that grain yield later on. And the optimal time is what we call first hollow stem. So this field that we are at right now, it's already greening up. And at this point, a very tiny head, or the reproductive point, starts to develop below the ground and at the crown level. Once that tiny head starts moving up the stem, if we maintain cattle on the wheat pastures, the cattle are going to start actually eating and removing those tiny heads. And so our yield reduces dramatically. When the wheat is past first hollow stem, we're losing anywhere from 1 to 5% per day. That might be up to 2 or 3 bushels of yield that we're losing per day. How do we look for first hollow stem? First, we need to go outside that wheat pasture, on that same field where the cattle are grazing. I would recommend just selecting the biggest tillers, because that's where we're going to see first hollow stem development first. Split these stems lengthwise, and if you can see a hollow stem that is about the diameter of a dime, or about 1/2 inch, well, that tells you that is an important time to remove cattle from wheat pastures.